Resilience for our biotics is important, and it is important regarding the business continuity, right? So this is a key aspect of our job to keep the roads operating and operating under the rules and the conditions set by the grantors in the different countries. These drive two major things, so we get two benefits from this resilience. The first is the risk reduction, of course, and the second one is also the predictability, which is also very important for us, not only from a financial point of view, but from the operational point of view. We have an example of a top measure regarding resilience. Of course, there are smaller examples or more precise examples in the business unit, but at the corporate level, we have done vulnerable and critical structures identification. That project, which took place a couple of years ago, and we have the output already, it's not about making a very complex thing, but to make to build up a catalog under the same rules and the same premises. And this catalog has driven measures for repair projects and for monitoring projects. So it has been really a tool for managing the company in another way and from another perspective. All right, not the worst first or other strategies, but more based on data and harmonized data and processes. The first challenge for us regarding resilience is anticipate the consequences of the different scenarios that we have, and monitoring and controlling. These are the two major challenges that we have regarding the resilience. For the tools, one of the things that we definitely have headroom for improvement is the communication, the link with grantors, not only the grantors, but with the administration regarding resilience. I would point mainly two things, two aspects. One is the communication plans, and the other is the coordination within these plans, all right? So when a major event happens, there's always headroom for improvement, and the lessons learned are after the things have happened. And what if scenarios and having thought about that would help not only in the resolution of the events if they ever occur, but also in reducing and mitigating. Because if when you think about the consequences it has, is when you allocate the resources more properly. And this is the challenge that we're right now focusing on.